History has proven that murals are not just a form of art, but documentation and demonstration of how communities existed. Murals told stories of hunting, religion, and everyday life. As communities developed, so did the murals. They became more sophisticated in colors, subjects, and styles. Each community developed its own style over time. The subjects on the murals became more personal and unique, from the murals in the Egyptian tombs to the murals of the Mayans and Aztecs. Native Americans created murals in the United States to show their way of life. Murals can be a tool to show local communities and the entire country, including the political structures, the accomplishments of those communities. Through our art and presentation skills, we show that art and artists cannot be ignored or neglected. The Santa Anita Mural Project is one of many avenues for celebrating the past, educating our youth, and unifying the people toward progress for a viable future.
One neighborhood in Santa Ana is taking a unique approach. The city is inviting local and international muralists and soon the community to use their talents on walls that are often graffiti targets. Orange County reporter Jessica DeNova has the story.
It's a work of love and activism. The side of the Lucky Center Market, 8 artists are contributing their ideas.
The bald eagle is the American and the other eagle, Mexicans, showing that we are all Americans of Mexican descent.
Research ensuring the work gives locals pride in their history.
We're trying to reflect on what the community was and how positive we can make those images for the community again with this mural.
They're respected, right? Because they do give identity to a lot of our neighborhoods and a lot of our culture. And it is something that's uniquely ours.
I was approached by the president of the Santa Anita Community Association. So we start getting an idea and we start forming the sketches. This mural is going to hopefully create a positive effect. That's what my goal is. Okay. I'm getting different styles of muralists together, I mean artists together, that have different talents, different creativities, but putting them together to keep your body beautiful by putting murals and color in there. And Santa Ana is leading the way throughout the county, throughout Southern California, actually. Because, like Santa Ana, not only with the arts, is also declared August Chicano Heritage Month.
My goal in Santa Anita was to remove any barriers that existed. This is a neighborhood that has had very unique challenges, but challenges that aren't unique to these neighborhoods. I just remember talking to some of the residents in the community. My family lives off of Laurel Street, and some of the residents in the community saying, there's gangs that are always tagging on these walls. And one of the residents who's older said something to me that I loved, and this is an older woman, and she was probably 75, 76, and she tells me, she goes, what's really funny about people writing on these walls? She goes, these walls don't belong to any of them. She goes, they belong to us. And that is what this mural reminds me of. This mural will show you the stories of people that live in Santa Anita. And I want to send a big congratulations to all the artists involved. Thank you for helping rewrite the Santa Anita story.
Mural, and then I kind of prefer the parrot over the eagle. I feel like the eagle's more of an aggressive image that they wanted to put in there.
My idea was more Azteca. It's a lot more simple. And here are just little pencil line of how the two faces are gonna look. The one thing I like about mine is that it's actually on the wall and you can see how it's gonna look exactly.
I like it without the letters just because images, it's like 5 panels. And we could literally add more panels if we wanted.
My idea was basically our idea since week one, that we agreed that we like 8 lettering design. So I put that in my sketch to show the sense of like community and where we came from and that like we're proud.
Yeah. Bree?
Okay, so my last two designs I came up with was based off of kind of both historical images of the community. So I just blew up these images that way. They are larger because we do have like the trees and the poles and the electrical box in the front. I thought if we had bigger images, even with those being in the way, it would still be easier to see from people driving down the street.
Okay, in mine, I put the lettering. I had the lettering in the middle coming out. So I put it in that angle because
when you have that lettering going across and the mural in front of it, it kind of takes away from the mural in itself. Mm-hmm. Because I think it does make a great statement, and it's a little bit powerful in there. I put this, the market where we're going to have the mural on there, in there. And on this side, I put Calva Dairies.
Give me a call. Let me know what it is, what you need. If I can get it, I'll do it. If I can't, I'll know. Drawing stuff. Don't hesitate to communicate. Please don't hesitate.
Oh, yeah. Okay. That, don't worry about that stuff.
Hi, I'm Brianna Negretti. I'm a local artist here in Orange County, California. The work that I create is based on nostalgia and symbolism. I started creating art when I was younger. Even in school, I was always acknowledged for my artistic abilities.
So I was approached about the Santa Anita Mural project by Abram Moya. And I thought it was exciting because, you know, we're going into another neighborhood that needs its own form of beautification. And it was bringing more of a positive light to that neighborhood and to the people that live there. The process of painting the mural was a lot of fun. A lot of the members of the community would come out and ask us what we were painting, and they were giving us ideas on what they wanted to see. So it was continuously developing, even in the middle of painting the mural. And I really enjoyed meeting the people in that community because they were so helpful with their own history that they could give us. And also, you know, even helping us paint the mural, we had a couple of individuals that were coming every so often to help us paint. I did enjoy working with the other artists on the mural. We all gave each other kind of critiques and information on how to paint, or excuse me, techniques on how to paint something different, or maybe you should do it this way, maybe you should have this type of color. And in that aspect, we were really able to kind of come together and create a mural that was unified.
Hi, my name is Rogelio Reyes, but I'm better known as the artist Roger Izar. I primarily work here in Santa Ana, where I live and grew up in. And I got started pretty young, like lots of other artists do. I was in kindergarten when I got the bug. I got some of my work up on in an exhibit that I wasn't old enough to go to. So I think what really helped me or encouraged me was to see artwork in my city. I started seeing Emilio Vasquez artwork, murals. Started noticing Sergio Ocariz work also, although at the time I didn't know who they were, but I started seeing artwork and it interested me. And I understood that that was, an artist did that, and that's what I wanted to do. A lot of the times when I'm doing work out in the community, I make sure to reach out to them, say hello, especially children, because again, that's when I was most influenced, and that's what it's all about. I just want to share what I do. And I think that art, or public art in general, is very powerful and very important, especially in my city. This is why it's important to me, because it's not only my art or my contemporaries' art, it's for everybody. It's their art, especially when we go into a neighborhood and talk to the people there. And in fact, when we can get them to participate, it means the world to them and to me. More than just beautifying an area, but really it builds pride, it builds community. And that's why we're here. I think, or what I really feel fortunate enough is to work in the city that I grew up in, work alongside beautiful, talented individuals in the service of others. I wouldn't know what else to do with myself. This really was my calling from the get-go. I don't know anything else but this, and I wouldn't have it in any other way.
My name is Ty Nguyen. I am 20 years old. I'm currently a student at UCI. And I got to art when I was really young, and then I kind of stopped for a while, and then I got back into it. That's when I started working with Abraham. and worked on the mural at the Heritage Museum, and that's how I got connected to this mural. Yeah, I got connected to this mural through Abe, and he was directing it, and he asked other artists to be with it, so I figured it would be a good experience since I was gonna be an art teacher anyway. And yeah, it's good practice, it's fun, it's a way for me to relax from all my schoolwork. I think this mural is important because it represents the community and the history, because history is also important when it comes to like politics and just bringing the community together. I think bringing the people together is the main purpose. This kind of tells a story of the past, the present, and the possible futures for the people living in this area. What's great about a mural is that it stays for a really long time through generations. So the kids that are living in here now, they're gonna see it. And once their parents, their kids are gonna see it. And I think that's a great point, because not that much thing stays like this forever.
Hello, I'm Artista Marina Aguilera. I'm a local artist of Southern California, but my love and my passion belong to the city of Santa Ana. I, as a child, drew ever since I could put a pencil in hand, and I've loved creating all my life. By myself and other young artists, when we were probably in our 14, 15 teenage years, starting then, we had painted many inspirational and cultural murals throughout the city of Santa Ana, maybe 30 to 40, from the early 70s to the late 70s. And the community embraced us, they embraced the art, they felt a connection and an inspiration with this beautiful art that was connecting them and others in the city and throughout the community. Now, 40 some years later, we are reconnecting again with passion and love and the heart of the community to be part of this and to be inspired and leave a legacy for generations to come so that they can enjoy and be fulfilled with beautiful art. As far as the green parrot that's here, actually the beginnings of this green parrot started in the community of Santa Anita, where I was a little girl, and there was a mom and pop pet shop, and the birds escaped a fire, which was across the street from where I lived as a child. And it was so surreal. They were escaping and they were in a beautiful sky like today. And they were going around in circles and didn't know where to go because they were pets. And for one great moment, they were up in the sky circling above me. And here we go, 40 some years later, we have all these amazing green parrots throughout the city of Santa Ana. So I just wanted to visually represent that in part of the mural that was a collaboration of great artists and community.
Anytime I'm at a wall, though, it's something special because it's public art, usually in the neighborhoods or accessible to people. And that's something that's really important to me. I like my art, or just art in general, to be accessible to folks. Especially out here in Santa Ana, a lot of people don't make it out to galleries or museums. So, you know, when you put it on the wall, to make sure that they're gonna take a look at it, and it's something that they're actually gonna enjoy.
I've been doing this since I was a little kid. Well, not murals, but doing art. And because of Abe, that guy right there, I really got involved into the community and doing giant murals along other artists. It's a really good learning experience. People actually get to see the process of creating art, because art is not always just boom, here is the painting that suddenly appeared. No, like, it takes time. We've been working on this for weeks now, and because we all have our own lives, we're kind of taking our time on it, but, you know, we just wanted to make it better. We can't just rush through it, but what's the point in that? There's no enjoyment and there's no sense of community in just rushing through a project.
This is Jonathan Williams working with an icon of Higgy Vasquez, the legendary icon of the son of the legendary Chicano artist, the godfather of Chicano art, Emigio Vasquez. Higgy Vasquez is an icon and a legend in himself.
My name is Joe Gonzalez. My dad came over here in the 40s, raised me and 11 kids on the next street, and this is Gunther Street. This is my dad right here. His name was Desiderio Gonzalez.
And people like him supporting this and working with this helps us out, helps this community out, and helps the mural. It not only helps the community, but helps us the artists also. You know, because they show their appreciation for us, the artists, and especially Chicano artists.
I'm Desiderio Gonzalez Jr. This is my father. He came here to Santa Ana in the 1940s, and he settled here and raised his family here. And we're still here in the area. Well, this represents the community, and we're really happy that the community has really taken heart to this, and they've accepted it, and hopefully it'll continue and it'll expand. Good vibes here.
Hello, I am the manager of the store. When I see all the pictures, I see how to live together. There is the Mexico and the eagle of the America is just like a community.
Hi, I'm Melinda Martinez, and this is my daughter Bella Calderon, and we're helping here with the mural, make it look beautiful for the neighborhood. And my daughter is on here too.
This
is my daughter.
The one right here. Oh, lovely.
Destiny Calderon, yes.
Oh, thank you.
She passed away 4 years ago from leukemia.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yes, so we're here helping, making it look beautiful.
Hi, my name is Ruben Calderon. Yeah.
I brought you guys some drinks.
Oh, you're so sweet. Well, thank you so much.
Yeah, appreciate you guys doing this, you know? Makes it look way better, it looks good.
Appreciate you. Thank you very much.
You guys for the heat, you know?
Thank you.
Thank you guys. Appreciate it, huh? Have a great day.
Thank you very much. Take care.
My name is Cheryl Garcia. I'm the daughter of Irma Garcia. I'd say a leader of the community. She worked at Russell School as a teacher at Santa Anita Park. She helped that grow back when it first started.
There's so much richness and culture in our city. Each neighborhood has a story to tell. You say you're from Santa Ana with pride, right? And that's something that I see a lot more people saying, is that they're proud of where they come from. And to all of you who are part of the neighborhood who inspired the work, you inspire us to do better. We need more beauty, we need more art, and we need more of our culture to be told.
My dad, who grew up over on Hazard and New Hope, he worked at Red's Ranch Market. Reminds me of my dad and the hard work that I know that I was brought up as a value that was very important, as I know as it is in this community. So with that, I want to go ahead and turn the mic over to Councilmember Jonathan Ryan Hernandez.
I'd like to think that murals in cities like Santa Ana represent that. It represents that we're not letting go of our culture, and that no matter what challenges we go through, we will use the most beautiful of ways to tell those stories. What this mural did was it brought people together, and it sent a message that none of these walls belong to any of us, but they do belong to the people. And people like Joe helped us build that bridge so that this community looks at this mural and sees a reflection of themselves. So I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart for that.
I grew up maybe 2 miles from here, and it felt like we were in totally different worlds despite all being Santa Ana residents. And I'm so glad that as the first Asian American woman on this dais and the first Vietnamese American, that we're building community with each other. that we're building bridges and we're supporting each other and telling our stories.
My name is Abram Moya Jr. I am a Chicano artist. I am not a Hispanic artist. I'm not a Latino X artist. I am a Chicano artist, an American of Mexican descent too. And I was asked by Mr. Felipe Guerrero to put a group together to do an art and a mural. What I did is I produced and I brought in seven professional top artists. One couldn't make it because he's far away. The other one got ill during the middle. But Mr. James Rocha was very much part of this. You have here, when this mural is unveiled, you will see one of the most professional murals done by professional artists in the most articulate way. It presents the history of this barrio. But there's two other people that I forgot to mention that we have to thank, and thank a lot because for their participation. The first is the owner, Ray. He gave us permission to do the mural on the wall. Without his permission, we could not do the mural. So we have a certificate. And the second one is a photographer and a documentarian. We're doing a documentary on the process of this mural. His name is Jonathan Williams.
All right, let's go.
One,
two,
three.
Through this presentation, we have shown to the community that individual artists with different styles along with community members can produce a wall of beauty. Just as Cesar Chavez stated, si se puede, yes you can, and as we artists have shown, we can work together to get a positive future, not only for us, but mainly for the young. As the words Unidos Venceremos state, united we shall overcome, as Chicanos we will prevail. In conclusion, I call on all youth and adults to encourage their local governmental system to create murals and beautify their communities using the positive tool of art.